Hey, what's going on, guys? USG Gamer here. Today, I'm going to be teaching Affinity and XP farming. If you guys didn't know, Affinity is the system for XP in Warframe. First, I'm going to have to break it down. So you get Affinity from leveling up Warframes, primaries, secondaries, melees, arc guns, sentinel, and companions. Not sure if completing missions or getting the codex done gets you Affinity, but it may be another way, so it doesn't hurt to look that up. So currently, I have my Neza Prime. What I got currently going on is I have a Neza Prime that I had to level up. How am I going to do this? Well, it gets broken down into a couple of parts. First, how Affinity works is you have 100% Affinity, and it gets broken down among different components of your loadout. So guaranteed 25% of your Affinity will go straight to your Warframe. The rest of the 75% will go among these three slots. If you only have one weapon, it'll get all 75% of the XP. Affinity boosters are key to making this a lot easier. And don't burn yourself out on this. You can get so easily burnt out leveling up weapons. Another thing you can do to make your life easier for Affinity grinding, because it never hurts to grind for Affinity. There are so many perks. You get higher master rank, you get to flex, you unlock new weapons, you get more void trace slots, you get Warframe slots. It never hurts to farm. So one thing you can do to make it easier is craft a bunch of weapons before you ever do anything. Now, yes, this gets very expensive and you will need to farm credits. If you want to check out my previous credit farm tutorial, I believe I have a credit farm tutorial. If I don't, I'll upload one. But go to the index, go to a dark sector, farm credits, boom. This will fund everything in here. It is resource demanding, but it is insanely fast affinity farming. You do the same in secondary, melee, and arcwing too. So, what I have here is my new helmet. It is quite interesting looking. It's really cool, but it is not cute. What do I name this dog? We'll do old meme that works. Can I do this? No, I can't disrespect that. We'll do Amber. Bird. Is this allowed? Yes. Boom. Alright, new dog. Who dis? That was pretty cool though. I like the art. This is really cool art and it's well done. Alright, cool. Ember is in great shape. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna equip that in my sentinel slot. Free XP reminder. You know. Let's just get it. Amber Heard has not been matured. Mature for combat. Oh Jesus. Looks huge. Alright, so my next step is choosing a mission. Now, defense missions are the best for affinity farming, by far. Undoubtedly the best. So, realistically, you can farm at any planet, but there are some better than others. I do not recommend going to Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, or Phobos. Any planets beyond that are okay. And most people will go, boom, Sedna, Hydron. I do not like Hydron. Two reasons. It is the furthest in the star chart, so it's not accessible for most players. And look at the resources. Rubido alloy plates salvaged and detonite ampules. These aren't the best resources you can farm. You might get levels slightly faster, but that isn't necessarily true. What I truly do recommend, going to Saturn, going Helene. It's a lower level mission, it's easier for more players to get to, and you'll find some way better resources. Plastids and organ cells. You may find yourself always needing these. So I highly recommend going to Saturn, farming this, because organ cells are always necessary. It never hurts to farm them, just like it never hurts to farm XP. So I would queue Helene, go there, get as many kills as possible. So we got going on. I got my helmet charger, looking icy. Two organ cells already. That's huge. Make sure you always run a vacuum link or fetch on your companions, as this will allow you to get more. So, I'm just going to do everything I classically do. Spam your abilities, though. Abilities will probably get you the most XP in the game. So, my helmet charger getting kills. It's already level 2. And it's actually rank 3. Because you also get bonus affinity. So, be cautious of that. You know, don't stay in a mission too long because you're wasting your time. Now, another aspect I want to explain to you is affinity sharing. currently in the top right of my screen, you will see a triangle with three circles with number three below it right next to my health and shields. Now, this is the amount of people that are in my area that I can farm an affinity from. This is the shared affinity system. This is the best way you can get it, is staying within your three range. Now, let me explain to you what happens if you get out of range. Two, one, and... No, just one. Okay. Because if you get out of range of all players, you will not be able to get any benefits from doing this. This is why defense missions are great. In areas where it's practical to move, you will get XP. It's that simple. Just don't go straying off and standing in the far side of the map. You just won't do anything. Now, with standard Warframe etiquette, do not AFK, as people will never like you, and you will be remembered. For some reason, they will find you. I've been in games where they found an AFK guy that was in their game before and just leave. It's quite interesting. So, do not go AFK and stay till round 10. That's what I recommend. You know, it's just a general standard that you do that out of just respect. Anything beyond that is a little bit extra, but round 10 is pretty much the social minimum. Now it is acceptable to sit and play your sousers in, otherwise anything else is not acceptable. Alright, so after the mission, we got our Nezza Prime to rank 25, our dog to rank 17, got two Orican cells in the, and we got two Mezzo relics, so never hurts to get more relics, even though it can get quite irritating to have a collection. So yes, to recap, it never hurts to farm Master Rank. It will always help you. It'll always help you progress, it'll make you look better, it'll make you play better, it'll teach you the ways and teach you new ideas and weapons to play with. Here's what I'm going to recommend. Hellion on Saturn or any defense mission. Put Hydron in second place just out of respect and do what you want. Truly, Warframe is about doing what you want to do and having fun with it, because the last thing you want to do is get burnt out, which can happen all the time. So do be cautious. Control yourself when you're playing Warframe. Don't blow through all your money when getting weapons, but do blow through some of it, I recommend. And you will need a lot of Forma to farm Affinity. For your Kuba weapons and to build certain weapons, like clan weapons, you will need Forma. So yes, thank you for watching. I've enjoyed this so much, this journey of 30 subscribers. Doesn't seem like a lot, but it means a lot to me, as I thought the channel was going to flop before it even hit 20. So this is just insane. Also got 31 subscribers, so thank you so much for subscribing. I could try to thank you guys individually, but some of them don't notify me, most likely because they might not be public or some setting. I can see a lot of them, and I greatly appreciate everyone that subscribes and watches the content. So if you stay till the end, thank you so much.